So now we're going to start with cell cycle and cell division. Okay, so cell cycle and cell division, as the name states. Okay, so basically you have two types of cell cycle. You have two types of cell division, mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis and meiosis are the two types of cell division. Okay, now, so first of all, let's see in detail about cell cycle and then we'll move on to the cell division. Okay, so what is a cell cycle? Every cell, it is actually produced, it will divide, grow and it will die. So this is how the cycle goes. Okay, and every cell has to follow this cycle. Okay, if cell is not dying, it will end up in a problem. If cell is not being made, it will end up in a problem. So everything should happen in the proper pace. So let's see how is this cell cycle happening. Okay, if you see the cell cycle, I can divide the entire cell cycle. So why should the cells divide? Is that my cells should divide to maintain to increase the volume. Okay, so for increasing the volume, for maintaining my nucleocytoplasmic ratio. Okay, to increase the DNA content, okay, to grow, to repair, to regenerate, to work, to metabolize, for all these things, my cells should divide and grow. Okay, how is it happening? How is the cell cycle, first of all? So if you see the cell cycle, okay, I can divide the cell cycle broadly into two types. One is M phase and the other one is interphase. So in this interphase, there is no division. Whereas in M phase, the cells will divide. Okay, in interphase, the cells will not divide. Whereas in M phase, the cells will actually divide. Okay, so let's see what are all there in interphase. Okay, so if you see this interphase, okay, I can say four. G0, G1, yes, G2. Okay, in this G0 phase or quiescent phase, okay, so CENT, okay, in this G0 or quiescent phase, whichever cells are going to undergo division will not enter this phase. If the cells do not want to divide at all, okay, I don't want to divide, that's it, I'm done, they will enter this G0 phase or quiescent phase. Okay, but if the cells are planning to divide, okay, then they'll be in any of these phases. But if they're not at all dividing, they'll be in the dormant phase. Okay, that is your G0 phase. G1. G1 phase is a gap between your M phase and then your synthesis phase. Okay, between this phase and this phase, this is a gap. Okay, so during this phase, okay, the nucleus will be metabolically active. The organelles will be metabolically active. But they'll not divide. Okay, they'll be at rest. Okay, so G1 is a gap one. S is synthesis phase. So in this phase, DNA replication happens. So DNA replication will happen only in the S phase or synthesis phase. Okay, synthetic phase. So what happens here is there is no division, but the amount of DNA will grow massively. Okay. The DNA will divide, but there is no raise in chromosome number. DNA content will grow more, but the chromosome number will be the same. Okay, I mean it will be there will not be any ploidy things added. The set will be the same. Okay, 46 chromosomes will be there. Okay, but the DNA will be replicating. Okay, and S2 is a gap 2 phase, and this is the gap between your synthesis and division. Okay, so this is a gap between your normal cell and the cells which are going to undergo replication. Replicated cell and the cell which is undergoing division, the gap is G2. Okay, so these are all the phase interfaces. Okay, the subdivisions of your interface. I repeat, G0, G1, S and G2. G0 dormant, cells will not divide if it is in that stage. G1 gap 1, S is synthesis, DNA replication happens. G2 is your gap 2 phase. Okay, So during synthesis, you know how DNA replication happens, correct? So it is a semi-conservative method. So DNA is all doubled and it is all prepared. Okay. Now, what happens next is we have to see about the M phases. Okay. See, if you see the replication time and then the division time will vary from one organism to other. For example, the replication time of E. coli is only 20 minutes. Okay. Replication time of yeast is 90 minutes. The replication time of human cell is about 24 hours. Okay. So it will vary. The timings will vary according to the organism and according to the cell. Okay. Now coming to the M phase. Okay. I will divide the M phase. There are two types of cell division. One is mitosis and the other one is meiosis. Okay. So coming to mitosis, see both the things initially, what cells I have only diploid cells, correct? 2N, 2N. In mitosis, my 2N will divide into, the numbers will remain the same. This is doubled and is split. Okay. That is what is happening in your mitosis. Whereas in meiosis, it is first reduced to half and half. Then this is multiply. So that is why meiosis is called as reduction division. I gave you 2N cell, but ultimately you gave me 4N cell. So I'm reducing the chromosomal number in meiosis. And this happens in one step and this happens in two steps. Okay. So that is why meiosis is called as reduction division. Mostly meiotic divisions, I can see it in the germ cells or reproductive cells. Germ cells or reproductive cells will undergo your meiosis or meiotic division. Okay. Now, let's see about mitosis. Okay. Fine. So, mitosis, if I say, it is the normal division, normal in the sense, and it is the type of cell division found in almost all our body cells except my sperm. Reproductive cells. Okay. So, excepting the reproductive cells, all cells will exhibit this mitosis type of cell division. Okay. So, in mitosis, what is the importance of mitosis is the chromosomal number is maintained. There is no reduction. Okay. Mitosis will occur in four stages. Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. One more thing, all the cell divisions will start in first of all, the cell divisions will start by splitting up of your nucleus. Okay, that is your centromere. So that division of centromere is called as karyokinesis. Karyokinesis. So all my cell divisions will start with karyokinesis. And it will end up in cytokinesis. Cytokinesis is division of your cytoplasm. It will start in karyokinesis and end in cytokinesis. So now what are we going to see is how is this karyokinesis happening? How is this nucleus splitting is what we are going to see here. Okay. So first of all, prophase. Okay. Prophase is the phase in which, I'm just going to explain you, no writing, nothing. Okay. So what happens is in prophase, the chromosomes will start condensing. Okay, if you see in early prophase, the chromosomes are not visible. It will start condensing. So as it gradually grows, you can see the chromosomes like this. So it will start, even the ends will not be clear in the prophase. Okay, so but later slowly it will start condensing and you can see. Okay, so this is how the chromosomes will be in the prophase. Okay, fine. So during prophase, what happens is that the nuclear membrane will start disintegrating. Okay, the cell organelles like your Golgi, endoplasmic reticulum, all other organelles will start disappearing. Okay, but you can see them in the prophase. It will start disappearing. Okay, and then your So these are the main changes. Nuclear envelope and everything, all the cell organelles will start disintegrating. Okay. And the chromosomes will start thickening. Okay, chromosomal condensation will start taking place in prophase. Coming to your metaphase. In metaphase, what happens is that the chromosomes will start aligning. They'll start coming towards the equatorial plate. Okay, they'll start coming towards the center. So it will move towards the equator. Okay, so this type of arrangement is seen in the metaphase stage. And at the end of metaphase, all the chromosomes are properly arranged in the equatorial plate. Sorry. So all the chromosomes are very well aligned in the equatorial plate at the end of your metaphase. And if you see similarly, parallelly, I will have the centriole and the astral complex will start appearing. Okay, that is your mitotic spindle. Okay, so it will all start appearing. So now what happens? So metaphase, everything is complete. So in metaphase, nuclear membrane envelope is completely lost. Okay, organelles are all completely disappeared. Chromosome is properly condensed and it is aligned in the equatorial plate. And you can find the astral stars come, astral complex coming up. Okay, now what happens is that next in anaphase. Okay, so what happens in anaphase is that there's also one more phase, cytokinesis. So during anaphase, this astral complex will start pulling the chromosomes. So what happens is that the chromosomes, the centromere is broken here. The centromere breaks and it will pull in like this. Like this. So it will start moving towards the poles. Okay. So what happens here is mainly the centromere breaks in the anaphase stage. Okay. And then what happens? It will start moving towards the poles. So you can see the chromosomes in various shape, like your J, okay, then your T, L, okay, I, all these shapes you can see during your telophase. It will start moving towards the end. Okay. Sorry, anaphase. And then so in anaphase, it will start moving, and in telophase, the movement is complete, okay, and it is kind of divided, completely divided. So if you see the telophase, here it is moving, right? So you can see. So my telophase will be somewhere like this, okay. So in telophase, the chromosomes are completely moved and separated, okay. Now what happens? So in telophase, what happens? Slowly, the nuclear membrane will start reappearing, and it will start reappearing. Okay, and then what happens is a cytokinesis. That is nothing but the division of the nucleus. Division of nucleus. So what happens? The nucleus will divide into two, and the two separate cells are formed. Okay. So when the cytokinesis is happening, what happens? The nuclear membrane will start reappearing. All the organelles will start reappearing. Okay, the nuclear membrane will start reappearing. Okay, so it will start disappearing here, and the chromosomes will start getting light, becoming light. Here they're all condensed, they're moved. After a moment, there's no point to be condensed, so they'll start becoming light again. Okay, so here the nuclear membrane apparatus will come back, but the chromosomes will start becoming light. So this is how this mitosis will happen. Okay, I repeat, prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Okay, so we have one more type of cell division called meiosis, which we'll be seeing. So we started with cell cycle. We were seeing about the mitotic division yesterday. So in mitosis, what we've seen is we've seen four stages. One is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. In prophase, that is, you call it as prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase, I mean prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. So in this, if you see, the daughter cells are identical to the parental cells genetically also, okay. So there is no crossing over or anything in the mitosis 1. And mitosis, we find it occurring only in the body cells, not in the germ cells, okay. Now coming to your meiosis. Okay, so we're going to see about meiosis today. So meiosis is called as reduction division. Okay, I'll just tell you the rough chart. First is the meiosis starts in a reproductive cell. Okay, so the 2N will become N and N. So there is a reduction in the chromosomal number. Now this will divide into N. Okay, so if you see there are two steps, this is called as meiosis 1 and this is called as meiosis 2. Okay, so meiosis occurs at two stages, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Okay, now what is this meiosis 1? Okay, how many stages are there? So the actual reduction in the chromosomal number is happening only at your meiosis 1. The reduction in the chromosomal number happens because 2N is reduced to N and N. So first let's see in detail about the meiosis 1. Okay, so if you see meiosis 1 has got a lot of substages. That is your prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, and telophase 1. Followed by this, you'll have cytokinesis or division of cytoplasm. Prophase 1, this is the longest stage. Prophase 1 is your longest stage because prophase 1 has got many subdivisions. So let's see here. Okay, so if you take in this prophase 1, okay, I can divide this prophase 1 into, zygotine, pacotene, diplotene, and diakinesis. So let's see in detail about this. Okay, so if you see this leptotene stage, okay, so see this happens, the mother cells, that is your sperm mother cells and then ova, oogonia, okay. They all will have only diploid cells. So some of those diploid cells will undergo meiosis and they will form the haploid gamete. So that is how it works. Okay. So if you see this leptotene stage, in this stage what happens is that the chromosome will start condensing. Okay. So and what happens is that the chromosomes are found sticking to the nuclear membrane like this. So this it will be somewhat like this. So that is why this stage is called as Bokeh stage. Okay. So this is called as Bokeh stage because I can find the chromosomes sticking on to the ends. Okay. Next, coming to zygotene stage. In the zygotene stage, okay, pairing of homologous chromosomes occur. So what is this homologous chromosomes? Homologous chromosomes are, see, each of our cell, each of our diploid cell will have two set of chromosomes. One is one so on up to 23 and the other set is 1 so on up to 23. In this will be the paternal contribution, this will be the maternal contribution. Okay. So each of our body cells will have two set of chromosomes, one from the father and the other from the mother. Okay. Now, what is this homologous chromosome is that? This one and this one, okay, they are homologous chromosomes. Though their origin is different, but they both are the same chromosomes. So that chromosomes are called as homologous chromosomes. So this homologous chromosomes from the paternal and maternal origin will start pairing with each other. Okay. So technically if you see in zygotene stage, for example, this is first chromosome. Okay. So each chromosome will have four arms, right? So this only happens in the zygotene stage. Okay. Now these are called as bivalents or tetrads. Bivalents, two chromosomes. Tetrads, totally I have 1, 2, 3, 4. Four strands. So that is why I call it as a tetrad. Okay. So this stage, the pairing of homologous chromosomes happens and this is called as this happens in zygotene stage and these structures are called as bivalents. Generally it is said that the number of bivalents, for example, 1, 2, 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 the cell. For example, we have 23 bivalents. So this is a bivalent. This is one bivalent. So likewise, you will have 23 bivalents. So that will indicate the haploid nature of the cell. So 23 bivalents means, it means we have, we are all, our haploid nature is 23. Okay, and diploid nature is 46. Okay. So this happens in your zygotin stage, pairing of your homologous chromosomes. Then in Pankatin stage, crossing over or recombination happens. Crossing over or recombination. So the paired homologous chromosomes will cross over one another, and that will result in the recombination. So mixing of paternal and maternal characters will actually happen in your Pankatin stage. This crossing over is not seen in your mitosis. Okay. Crossing over happens only in the meiosis. Okay. So crossing over happens so that the characters and genes are mixed. Okay. So this crossing over is called as synapsis. Crossing over or synapsis will happen in the Pankatin stage. Then after crossing over, what happens is diplotin stage, the spindle, the astral complex will start appearing, and the chromosomes will be pulled. Okay, it will start pulling. Here, there is no breaking of centromere. In mitosis, when the pull is happening, see, in mitosis, this breaks into two. So the centromere is broken. Whereas here, there is no breaking of centromere. Just one set moves one side, the other set moves the other side. Okay. So just the movement of the homologous chromosomes towards the opposite ends will happen in the diplotin stage. Okay. See, if the crossing over has happened like this. So this is a crossover part. Okay. The point at which the crossing over is happening is called as chiasma. Chiasma. Okay. So this will, what happens is that at the point of chiasma, the two chromosomes will remain together. For example, how will I tell you? Okay, this is one chromosome. This is the other chromosome which has been crossed over. Okay, so what happens, it will not be separated as such. So the crossing over point at which, for example, this is one arm, okay, of this chromosome, and this is the other arm of this chromosome. So this point is your chiasma, and this remains in contact. Okay, and what happens is during diplotin stage, terminalization, that is the chiasma, will start moving to the ends like this. Okay, so terminalization of chiasma happens in this diplotin stage, and in diakinesis stage, after the separation, this will divide. The cytoplasm will also divide, and it will split into N and N in diakinesis stage, what happens is that this terminalization will be even more condensed, and what happens is that the nuclear envelope and all nuclear membrane will start disappearing. Okay. So this is what happens in your prophase 1. I repeat, first prophase 1, I have got many substages: leptotin, zygotin, pankatin, diplotin and diakinesis. In leptotin, it's called as bucket stage because the chromosomes are attached to the ends of your nuclear membrane. Zygotin, pairing of homologous chromosomes happen. Pankatin, crossing over will happen. Okay, that is the recombination. Diplotin, terminalization of chiasma will happen. Diakinesis, the two chromosomes are properly separated, and then the nuclear membrane will start disappearing. So this is what is happening in the prophase 1. Okay. Now in metaphase 1, what happens is that the crossed over chromosomes, till now there is no crossing over. Just now only the crossing over has happened. Before that, there is no crossover. So the crossed over chromosomes will arrange themselves in the equatorial plate like this. So, and in anaphase 1, the astral complex will start appear, and they will be moving on towards the ends. But here, as I told you, there is no breaking of your centromere. I told you before, when they are moving, there is no breaking. There is only the separation of your homologous chromosomes. So, anaphase will involve in movement of the paired crossed over chromosomes towards the ends. Telophase, what happens is that the movement is complete. So, what happens is that? So it will be like this in the telophase stage. Okay, and in cytokinesis, what happens? The cells will start deepening. There'll be a groove. The groove will deepen, and then the 2N is divided into N and N at the end of your meiosis one. Okay. So the 2N is divided into N and N at the end of your meiosis one. Now in meiosis two, what happens is that, okay. So again in meiosis two, from this N I have to give rise to N and N. What happens? This will multiply first. Okay. And as usual, the stages which I have in meiosis two is that. Prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, and telophase 2. What is this 2-2 is that? Here, just like that, there will be a synthesis happening. Okay, after that, what happens? The haploid set will arrange themselves. So, prophase, what happens is that same as usual. So, in prophase, the nuclear membrane will disappear, organelles will disappear. Okay. Chromosomes will start condensing. Same thing will happen here. But here it is only the haploid set, not the diploid set. Okay. It is similar to mitosis, except to the fact that there it is 2N, here it is N. And that's it. Okay. So in metaphase 2, they will align. These haploid set will align themselves. The synthesized haploid will align themselves in the equatorial plate. Then there will be a separation. After anaphase, there will be a movement. And telophase, there will be a separation. So this is how the meiosis will happen. Okay, so meiosis 2 is similar to mitosis actually. Okay, so what happens is that if you see mitosis, you can observe mitosis in almost all the body cells, but meiosis, it is very specific only in the reproductive cells. Okay, so in this meiosis also, meiosis 1 is little different and complicated, but meiosis 2 is similar to the mitosis. Okay, now as I told you, the cell growth and cell multiplication is very important. As you know, these cells will exhibit a mechanism called as contact inhibition. So what happens is that when each cell is coming in contact with other cell, the multiplication will stop. This is called as contact inhibition mechanism. This mechanism is lost or not seen in cancerous cells, because cancerous cells will not follow a discipline of multiplication. They'll just grow randomly, rapidly and incompletely. Okay, so that will make the normal cells devoid of the basic nutrients, food and other things which they have to acquire. Okay, so that is the main problem with your cancerous cells. Okay, so cancerous cells has lost the contact mechanism, and there is a proton called as P53 proton which will check your cell cycle. Okay, so this P53 is also used as a medication for this cancerous people these days. Okay, so and then as long as cancer is concerned, you know, there is the cell cycle is only hindered there. Okay, it is not multiplying properly, it is not following the rules, that is in G1, S, G2 and then mitosis phase. This is not being following up properly, and that is why it is resulting in the cancer. And then mitosis and meiosis, okay, if you see that is required, see for example, we call it a cell division, but the mitosis itself is the mode of replication in the lower organisms. For example, 2N dividing into 2N, that is reproduction in E. coli. Okay, we call it a cell division, but that is the reproduction in E. coli. So likewise, mitosis is very primitive, and that has its uniqueness right from the primitive organisms. Okay, and then if you see meiosis, okay, I told you this reproductive cells will only undergo meiosis. Okay, so the cell which is undergoing meiosis here is your mother cell. Okay, and from 2N to N, the reduction you can see happening only from the primary to secondary site. The primary spermatogonia or primary spermatid, primary oogonia, the oocyte, these are all diploid. But the secondary spermatid or spermatogonia and secondary oogonia are haploid. So till primary, okay, that is mother cells, till primary they'll remain diploid. And from primary to secondary only the reduction happening. That is why I'll call meiosis as reduction division.